Approximately 8 joiners, 4 plumbers, 6 electricians, 20 tradesmen die each week from the effects of asbestos.
This was a TV advertisement by Health and Safety Executive of UK for the awareness of the use of asbestos years ago. Asbestos is a group of 6 naturally occurring silicate minerals made up of thin microscopic fibers. These are useful because of their excellent tensile strength, poor heat conduction and resistance to chemical attack. Asbestos materials have been used for insulation in buildings and in various products such as roofing materials, water supply lines and clutches, brake linings, gaskets, and pads for automobiles. Asbestos was once used in thousands of products. Regulations prevent many new products from containing the mineral, but some illegally contain low levels of asbestos. Manufacturers are also not required to disclose asbestos in the ingredients list if there is less than 1% asbestos. Asbestos is banned in more than 55 countries around the world, including Japan, Australia, and all countries in the European Union. Iceland was the first to ban asbestos imports due to health concerns in 1983, followed soon after by Sweden. Germany banned asbestos in 1992 and UK did so in 1999. However, it continues to be used around the world, especially in Asia and Russia, and in small amounts in the US. So why does these countries ban asbestos? Before moving forward, please subscribe this channel for more information related to nature, sustainability and energy. When materials that contain asbestos are disturbed or damaged, fibers are released into the air. When these fibers are inhaled, they can cause serious diseases. These diseases will not affect you immediately. They often take a long time to develop, but once diagnosed, it is often too late to do anything. The most common way for asbestos fibers to enter the body is through breathing. In fact, asbestos-containing material is not generally considered to be harmful unless it is releasing dust or fibers into the air, where they can be inhaled or ingested. Many of the fibers will become trapped in the mucous membranes of the nose and throat, where they can then be removed, but some may pass deep into the lungs or, if swallowed, into the digestive tract. Once they are trapped in the body, the fibers can cause health problems. Asbestos causes cancers of the lung, ovaries and larynx, and is suspected to cause others, including gastrointestinal cancer. Medical experts say there is no evidence for a threshold of exposure for cancer. Any amount of airborne asbestos fiber poses a risk. Smoking is known to increase the risks of lung cancer with asbestos exposure. The World Health Organization estimates that around 125 million people are exposed to asbestos in the workplace, and that at least 107,000 people die each year globally from occupational exposure to airborne fibers. The burden of asbestos-related diseases is still rising, even in countries that banned the use of asbestos in the early 1990s. Demolishment of old asbestos structures, roofs and partitions will cause suspension of asbestos fibers in the air. Older asbestos-containing products can become exposed from damage, wear and tear or other disturbances. For example, buildings and homes built before 1979 likely contain asbestos materials that haven't been replaced or removed. Asbestos particles are not typically visible to the naked eye and are odorless. As a result, people are unaware of their exposure. So everyone should seek professional help for asbestos handling and disposal.